Lisa.
Adam.
Elisa.
Adam.
Elisa.
Adam.
Elisa.
Thank you.
The coffee tasted different. Did it taste different because you made it instead of the other usual barista? Or did it taste different because he made it and I'm starting to feel dizzy? Or did it taste different because of the taste in my mouth? Or did it taste different because of the nature of the coffee itself? Or did it taste different because of the soy milk? Or did it taste different because he made it? Or did it taste different because he made it?
Was the last word I was able to speak aloud. Which is a terrible thing, but there it is. I would walk around the neighborhood saying, I. You want a cup of coffee, Thomas? I. And maybe something sweet? I. How about this weather? I. You look upset, is anything wrong? I wanted to say, of course. I wanted to ask, is anything right? But instead I said, I wanted to pull the thread, unravel the scarf of my silence, and start again from the beginning. I know I'm not alone in this disease. You hear the old people in the street, and some of them are moaning, I. But some of them are clinging to their last word. I, they're saying. Because they're desperate. It's not a complaint, it's a prayer. And then I lost eye, and my silence was complete.
Thank you.
have this poem that I've written about 100 times, scribbled it over countless notebooks and scraps of paper, and set fire to it on 15 different occasions. I write it and imagine giving it to you, but I get so scared that you'll shake your head and tell me you don't trust a word I say. So I just screw it up really small and stuff it down the back of bus seats. So I guess you'll never know.